How do you do, guys? Welcome to today's edition program with CV. This is a C# tutorial. We're going to see how we can load an image from the file system, of course, right here into our form, and then of course draw a string onto it. Now you can see, for example, this enchilada, this is a string. We're going to draw it using the graphics class, okay? So you can see we have, of course, the enchilada right here. We've drawn it, of course, onto our image. Now we have also drawn a frame right here around the image, and then of course we've painted it as gray. So this is something we're going to look at, and we'll see how to actually do it using the, of course, graphics class. Now this of course is the image right here. You can see these are the image that we're going to work with, okay? Of course you can see it, of course, in the explorer. Now when it comes to our Windows form, you can see that we've loaded it and drawn some string to it. Now this is what we're going to see, okay? So let's get started. Okay, so first and foremost, you're going to start by creating a simple project. Now we're going to make it into a console application before turning it into a Windows form application. So come choose the console application, then click OK. This will create for us a console application. Then of course we're going to turn this one into a Windows form application. So come and add references. So we come right here and then search the system.windows. If you search, you'll see it right here. Just check it, and also search the drawing, which you're also going to use, system.drawing. These are two namespaces. Just click OK. They'll get added right here under our references. Now once we have them, then of course we can come and then import them. We're going to import the system.drawing and system.windows.form. Then of course we come right here, first have our class program. We're making it extend the form class. This will make this particular class a Windows form application. Now we're going to have several instance fields. First a pen object, second a solid brush object, and then we have two solid brushes, one we call brush, another one we call the black brush. Then of course we have the constant, which is going to be the path where our image is going to be located. Now you can see this is where I have my image located right here. This is my image, okay? Sencharas dot we have the sencharas dot jpg right here, okay? So we have it. Of course you can see the path, I have it under the D, under the resources, under the images. Now we come, we specify that particular path. We're marking it as a verbatim string, okay? Meaning that it's actually a raw string, a literal string. So here's the path, we can have it literally right here, given that you're using this verbatim string operator. Then of course we have an image object as well as a font object. Now we're going to have the first method called initialize component. First we'll suspend our layout temporarily, then of course instantiate our size right here, the client size for our form. We pass in the width and height respectively, then of course pass in the text or the title for the form, then of course resume our layout, invoke the resume layout right here, passing in false. Then of course we're going to have this method called initialize stuff. Now here first we're going to instantiate our color right here. We have a gray color as well as a light gray color, two color objects. Then of course we're going to instantiate our pen object, passing in, of course, as you can see, we pass in the color, okay, color gray, as well as the width of that particular pen. Now having done that one, we're also going to instantiate our solid brush object, passing in the color. Then of course our image, will load it of course from the file, and then of course the font, we're going to pass in a font family object. Now we're using the Times New Roman font as well as a font size of 20 right there. Then of course we'll come and have our sketch method. It's just a simple method. Now we're going to first start by instantiating the graphics class. So this particular method right here of course will give us an instance of the graphics class which we're going to use. Then of course we come right here. The first thing is to fill, of course, the interior of our rectangle, okay? Now you guys remember, our rectangle, of course, we'd actually painted it gray. Okay, so we come mgraphics.fillRectangle, then of course we are using the brush object. Okay, and remember our brush, we'd given it of course a light gray color, as you guys can see. So we come, of course we're going to pass in the X. First we pass in the brush which we'll use to fill it, and then we pass in the brush that we'll use to paint that particular rectangle. Then of course we pass in the X, okay, and then of course the Y, the X coordinate, the Y coordinate, the width of the rectangle, as well as the height of the rectangle. Now we've used the fill rectangle method. Then of course the next thing is actually to draw a rectangle, or to draw a frame around it. Okay, so we're going to come and invoke the draw rectangle method. Now we're going to pass right there the pen that we'll use to draw, then we'll pass in the X coordinate, the Y coordinate, and then of course the width, and then the height. Now once you've done that one, the next thing is now to draw an image. So we'll come and say mgraphics.drawImage, then we pass in the image that we'd love to draw, and then we pass in the X coordinate, the Y coordinate, and then the width as well as the height for that particular image. Then of course we'll come and then draw a string onto that particular image. So this is the string that we want to draw. We pass in the font for drawing it, and then the black brush is what we'll use to draw it, and then of course we pass in two floating point, that is the X and Y coordinates. Okay, now once you've done all those, then we need to release the resources which our graphics object was actually occupying. We release them by invoking the dispose method. Now having done that one, we're then going to override the onPaint method. This is one of the methods in the form class. So this method gets raised of course when a form is painted. We're going to receive a paint event tags object. Then here what we simply do is that we invoke the sketch method. Now the sketch method of course will sketch for us the image as well as the string onto that image. Then we come into our program class. First we initialize our components, then we initialize stuff. Okay, then of course that's it. We come have our main method. So in our main method, what will we do? Well, we're just going to invoke the run method and then pass in the instance of our program class. So that's all we need to do. Then of course we can then come and then run the project by clicking start, and then of course you can see our image has been drawn, our string has been drawn, we also have a frame drawn around it, and then we've also painted the rectangle right here. So this is what you've looked at, guys. Like this video, share it, and make sure you subscribe to our channel, Program Users TV. Otherwise, take care. I'll catch you in the next class.